When most quilters start free motion quilting, they usually start with stippling, but I don't recommend you do that. In today's video, I'm going to show you my best suggestions for quilting motifs when you're first starting to free motion quilt. Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst. I'm an online educator and the host of the Quilter's Way, the only online quilting club that combines learning with a fun, supportive community. Before we get into today's topic, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I have a new video. So typically you hear that you should start free motion quilting with stippling, but I do not think that that is the best quilt motif choice. So if you don't know what stippling is, sometimes people call it meandering, it's sort of like puzzle pieces. You're kind of going up and changing direction and over the side and down and all around. So much to think about. And when you're first free motion quilting, there are other things to think about too. So I always think it's best to simplify where you can. So what I suggest that you would do is, first off, watch my video, how to set up your sewing machine for free motion quilting. And if you haven't already seen that video, I'll put a link in the description below. And in that video, I want you to pay particular attention to when I talk about the speed control on my Janome sewing machine. So you may have a speed control on your machine as well. And what that does is it allows you to set the speed that the needle goes up and down on the sewing machine to a consistent rate. So talking about simplifying, if you can take out something that you don't have to take out something in that process so you don't have to think about it, that's going to simplify the process. So using your speed control to set the speed of that needle going up and down means that you really don't have to think much about it, because what you'll do is you will press your foot pedal all the way to the ground and it's just going to keep going at that consistent rate. Okay, that will take one thing out of your free motion quilting thinking that goes on. The next thing you want to do is you want to simplify the design that you're going to use. So you don't want to have to think about which direction I have to go and I have to change direction now and change direction now, as you would have to do in stippling. You want to do something simpler so you don't have to think too much about which direction you're going in. And I'm going to get to that in just a minute, but I do want to mention one thing that helps when you're getting set up for free motion quilting, and that is when you put your quilt sandwich together, instead of using pins, try my multi-purpose quilt spray. Now this is a do-it-yourself recipe. You can make it yourself with common household ingredients. So if you're not aware of how to do that and how to use that product, look in the description below, because I'll put a link to the recipe there. You're gonna love it. It's gonna make things so much quicker for you to do, so much easier, and you don't have to worry about getting stuck with any of those pins. Okay, so check that out in the description below. So let's take a look at a couple of the motifs that I think are a better choice than stippling when you're first starting to free motion quilt. So we're going to talk about waves first. Wavy lines, okay? Keeping it simple. So you have here this little wavy line that goes along. You're going up, you're going down, you're going up, you're going down. It's a repetitive motion that you'll soon get used to. You can go down and then up, you can go up and then down. You can go either direction you want to go, doesn't matter. But you can still do a lot with this design. You can make little short ones. You can decrease the distance between those little waves, if you will. You can make these higher, lower, whatever you want to do. So there's some options in there. But what it allows you to do is just make a repetitive motion as you go along, not having to think about changing directions. So that's one thing to do, waving. Another one you can do, a little bit more complicated, but not much, is loops. Again, it's a repetitive motion. You're going in a circle, you're coming out, change direction a little bit. Okay, you do change direction, but you'll get used to it. And then you go around. So you're going loop, around, change direction, loop, go around, change direction, another loop. Again, it's a repetitive motion. You're going to get used to that very easily. And both of these designs, the loops and the wavy lines, are foundational to other more complex free motion quilting designs that you can get into. So you're going to be able to use them in a lot of different ways in your projects. So forget the stippling, try waving and try looping instead. And if you have any suggestions for easy quilt motifs when you're first starting off in free motion quilting, put them in the comments below, I should say, because I'd like to know what those are. Thanks for watching today. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Be sure to share it with your quilting friends. And remember to subscribe and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I have a new video.